Is a good evening, except if I was being superwoman in my dreams last night and I woke up with my neck bent over, so I got a bit of a headache. Can't tell, can you? But I have. I thought I'm going to cook in my garden, just outside my kitchen door. I've got a little fire going on, and I haven't finished all this yet, but I'm going to make something with an aubergine. Now, for this aubergine curry, you obviously need one of those. And one chopped onion, two chilies, sliced long ways, about three fresh tomatoes chopped up. Then you've got the dry mix, which is about a teaspoon and a half of garam masala, about a teaspoon of chili powder, teaspoon of turmeric, and salt to taste, chopped coriander, and garlic and ginger, about four pieces of garlic and 1 inch of ginger, all chopped up. Oh, that's a bit of garam masala in there. So this is my little setup for now. Oh yeah, you need oil. And I'm gonna get cooking on my fire. How exciting. I thought my stand would be pretty good, but it's not. So I thought better off just using my hands and taking the video. So here is the fire going. In my little setup for the kitchen. So what we need to do is get the aubergine and put that onto the fire, like so. So we're just charring the skin of the aubergine. That gives it that lovely smoky flavour. Sound like Jamie Oliver there. Sorry, been watching a bit too many of his programmes. Easily influenced I am. Anyway, oh gosh. I wanted more flame than that. It's taking me ages to get the fire going. I think the charcoal's really damp. I'm lying around, all my dishes are waiting to be cooked. What? I think dodgy charcoal, it's really damp. After several attempts of trying to light that, there's only a few bits of coal that are actually lit. I put the aubergine on there anyway. So I'm just hoping that the skin crackles up a little bit. This could be an epic fail. Very slowly, it is slowly blistering now. I've got all the hot coals on that side. Wow, that's a bit hot. So while the aubergine is still getting cooked, I'm going to start making the base for this curry. So the oil goes in, about half a cup full of oil. Since it's taking ages, I'll just give that a while. Right, I'm going to add the onions into the oil. Let's see. Does it sizzle? Yeah, a little bit. Very slow cooking. This is actually quite good fun cooking outside. Ooh, even though it's a bit slow, I need to get new charcoal bits, I think. Those ones are too damp. And my aubergine is just getting charred over there. Let's put that back on the heat a little bit more and give it a stir. It's actually a very warm, not very warm, what am I talking about? It's probably about 7 centigrade in the evening. And with a little fire going on, it just feels like 20. But I've got my onions on the go, and I've got my aubergine. Right, so that's the aubergine done. So what you need to do now is take off all the skin. And that's what I'm going to do now. Just peel it off nice and hot. And the onions are making a move. Let's put that on the fire. Let it sizzle. So now I've just left a bit of skin on because I like the smoky flavour. Chop it up into small pieces. Chop, 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 chop. The onions are nicely browning. So until they are a softy brown colour. Oh, this is fun cooking outdoors. Thoroughly enjoying this. So we're now going to drop in the ginger and the garlic. Well, this is where it becomes really nice and smelly, and my next door neighbours are going to smell it and go, what the hell is she doing out here? Cooking! She's taking ages. I don't have a lot of patience. This curry would have been over and done with in about 10 minutes in my kitchen. So the onions and the garlic and ginger are nicely browning. I'm now going to add my seeds, which is the, cumin seeds and onion seeds. about 2 teaspoons of the cumin seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of the onion seeds. Pop them in and let it sizzle. Let that sizzle for a bit. And that's all sizzling away, the seeds. I'm going to add the dry mix, which is the salt, garam masala, turmeric and chili powder in. All that goes in. And I'm going to add in my fresh tomatoes. Yum yum. And let that fry off for a bit. Oh, it was just taking way too long on that barbecue. So I've cheated and come in and using the gas stove. So now that the tomatoes are frying away, I'm so looking forward to this curry tonight. I wasn't prepared to wait ages for it. Okay, cooking up nicely now, isn't it? So we're waiting for that oil to separate from the tomatoes. It's happening just now. So in goes the chopped up aubergine. That's done over the barbecue. So it should have that nice smoky flavour. Let me put your camera down. So the aubergine is in there now. Give that a good old stir. Because the aubergine is already cooked, I don't have to cook it for too long. And then I get my chopped coriander, pop that in. Oh, and my chilies, nearly forgot those. Pop that in. Give it a good old stir and let that simmer for about 5 minutes. And then you've got aubergine, smoky aubergine curry. Looks lush already. Outside though to heat my tortillas up on the barbecue. Just get them nice and warm and then I'll eat the curry. I'm so looking forward to it. Well, I'm going to taste it. So much quicker in there. But I'm sure it's the fire, not a great fire starter. And let's give this a go. So, aubergine curry. Oh God, that's rough. Mmm. Honestly, you're going to have to try this because it is a dish where you know you normally like put your nose up to an aubergine, but not this one. Mmm.